That came from the unseen world. That came from the same channel that we just go on the internet and get information. God will send that information down to the same channel. They had back in the days of the Second World War. I'm just going to give you this quickly. After you had the war, then you had a period with what they call the Cold War. America and Britain developed a way to give misinformation to the Germans because they wanted to influence the German population against the old government. So they set up a radio station. And they had a man called Stefan Delmer, a British journalist, but the guy was fluent in German. And they put him on the radio station, and he speaks fluent German. And they said, "This is Stefan reporting to you out of Berlin." They said, "The guy is not even in Berlin, the guy over in London. Talking like a German, laughing like a German, giving German information in the German dialect. Influencing millions of people in Germany. Because they knew they didn't need guns to go in and change Germany. All they needed was information. Give them bad information and they'll turn against their government." Long away on a radio. That has changed. Today you have Facebook, you have Twitter, you have Snapchat, you have all these media platforms that even ISIS has found a way, the terrorist organization, they have found a way to use all that information and spread propaganda. The guy never meet the ISIS leader. He never touch him one day. He never even have a conversation with him. But the guy sends him information over the internet. He decides to get in a van, drive down New York City, hit down 20-something people. And they say, "How come the guy is a terrorist? He's never been to Afghanistan. He's never been to Syria. He's never been to Iraq. He's been in the United States all his life. He's been living there for the last 10 years. How come he turned a terrorist?" The guy never leave his place of abode, but he was changed. His behavior was influenced to go and kill people via the internet. Information he was given over the web.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. You see, that kind of information is called black propaganda. Is it black propaganda? It's false information and material that purports to be from a source from one side of a conflict, when it's actually from the opposing side. Its typical use is to embarrass and misrepresent the enemy. Black propaganda is in contrast to today around the world. They have used that in the Arab Springs. Look how many governments in the Arab world have been overthrown. Did the CIA go in there? All they need to do, they go in that country and make sure they take over the channel of information they feed into the university and the young people, and suddenly they go and overthrow the government. Why? Information being fed. Because every one of them have a cell phone. I don't care if I die in the jungles of Africa or he's somewhere down in the Philippines in some little hole. You give him a cell phone, and you ask him, "Who is the president of the United States of America?" He said, "Donald Trump." How does he know that? He got a cell phone.
Yeah.
He might have people in the jungles trying to be Mariah Carey, trying to be Carrie Underwood, trying to be one of these kind of people. They never see him, they never been around him. Information, influencing behavior. Then tell me, if information given in a negative way can negatively influence behavior, what about when God decides to give us information from his word? What is that supposed to do to us as believers? Hallelujah! Samaritans. I'm a Samaritan. I am half Jew and half Gentile. I'm corrupt, as a matter of fact. Jesus says, you know who's talking to you. You are not gonna ask me why I will give you water to drink right now that you will never even have to come back to this well. She said, is that so?
Glory.
Brother Bram said he was carrying on a conversation to catch the woman's spirit. Our actions and reactions to him was based on who she perceived him to be. He was one of those mean Jews who come up there, and when they see a Samaritan, they turn their face the other way and walk away. When they stole the good Samaritan, the guy beat them and bleed him, and the priest crossed the street. So he said, if you have enough information that will decipher to you who's speaking with you right now, he said, you are going to ask me for water to drink, and I'll give it to you, and you'll never come back to the well. She said, I meet a lot of Jews. And I never ever meet a Jew who could do that. You just are not a Jew. He said, go call your husband. She said, I had no husband. What husband? He said, can you tell the truth? You have five of them and you're living with one right now. Right now you have one in your house who is not even your husband, somebody else's husband. She said, oh my God. Who tell him? Who give him that information? That guy was moving with me last night. I ain't tell nobody. My cousin don't know. My best friend don't know. My auntie don't know. How come he know that? I know something here. If you know all that, it means you connected to the person in the Bible who's supposed to come that we call Messiah. Yes, the Bible tells me when the Messiah comes, he has the ability to get information on people that they don't tell. Amen. He said, I am he who's talking with thee. She drops your water pot. Went through the city and tell every man, come see somebody who told me all things about myself. It changed her from that day from a prostitute to a Holy Ghost filled believer.
And so,
let me wind it down. The governments of the world have realized that information is influencing millions of people around the world. It's costing companies money. It's costing governments to lose the influence. So you know what they do now today? Yeah. Governments are hiring hackers around the world. They're hacking to other governments' database. To see if they can alter that information to give them the advantage over that next country. They say hacking in the past used to be something people go to jail for. Today when the government finds you to be a good hacker, they don't put you in jail. They put you in a nice 5-star hotel and say hack for us. They say all the major corporations around the world, because they want to influence the economics around their business and give them an edge. Even corporations are in hackers to hack another corporation. Because wars are no longer fought with guns and tanks. It's fought with information. Let me read you some of the close up here. Brother Ram said, he called information revelation. He said, revelation is necessary to give a church prevailing power. If a church don't have a revelation, that church dies. 7 church age. You see, I want to show you the reason why Satan hates Revelation and hates the book of Revelation. He said he knows that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever, and that God doesn't change. He knows a lot more than 90% of the theologians around the world. He knows that since God is immutable in his nature and is just as immutable in his ways, Satan knows assuredly that the original church at Pentecost, with the power of God and Mark 16 in action, is the only true church that Jesus claims to be his own.
Amen.
Everything else is false, and it has to be. Now remember, Christ in the true church is the continuation of the book of Acts. But the book of Revelation shows how the Antichrist spirit will come into the church, defile the church. How did he do it? By twisting the word, sending it to the Eve. He will make it lukewarm and formal and powerless. It exposes Satan, revealing his works, attempted destruction of God's people by doing what? Discrediting or sharing misinformation in the world. See? Right up to the time he's cast into the lake of fire, he fights Revelation. He cannot stand Revelation. He knows that if the people get the true revelation of the true church, and what she is, and what she stands for, and that she can do the greater works, that church will become an invincible army. If they get a true revelation of the two spirits within the framework of the Christian church, and by God's spirit discerning and withstand the Antichrist spirit, Satan becomes powerless before that church because she has revelation.
Amen.
He will definitely be thwarted today as when Christ withstood his every effort to gain power over him in the desert. Satan hates revelation, but we love it. With true revelation or true information, the gates of hell cannot prevail against us, but we can prevail over them. How do we do that? By revelation. You will recall that I mentioned at the beginning of this message that this book we are studying is actually the revelation of Jesus Christ. It goes to the book of Revelation. It's the revelation of Jesus Christ himself in his church and his work in the future ages. Then I mentioned it takes the Holy Spirit to give us revelation. We will fail to get it if he doesn't give it to us. Bringing these two thoughts together, you will see that it won't take just ordinary studying to make this book become real. It's going to take the operation of the Holy Ghost. That means the book can't be revealed to anyone but a special group and a special class of people.
Amen.
It will take one with prophetic insight. It will require the ability to hear from God. It will require supernatural instructions, not just studying and comparing one scripture verse with the next scripture verse, though that can be good. But a mystery requires the teaching of the Spirit, or it never becomes clear. How we need to hear from God and let ourselves open and become yielded to the Spirit to hear and to know. Let's stand. If we don't hear, then we become like those in the book of Acts, whose faith got overthrown because somebody was spreading misinformation on the gospel of Paul. Paul was the Alpha prophet. Brother Branham is the Omega prophet. You know what? Let me explain to you. Didn't God give what the Sadducees said and the Pharisees and the scribes? They took what Paul said and they twisted that. And they took message believers and overthrew them. Information warfare. In this age, you think you're going for what Jimmy Swaggart said, or what Billy Graham said? Or are they going and say, let me take what T.D. Jakes said and tell you that your message wrong? No. They take what you already have. And they tweet it. They twist it around, just like they did in the time of Paul. And the same effects that it had back then You have the same effects again now. Overthrow the faith of many. Information warfare in the human mind. That's why God has to raise up men like Brother John. And ministers who know how necessary it is to say exactly what that prophet said and never twist it.
Amen.
Don't add to it. Don't twist it around. Every age, he raises up faithful ministers who sticks with the message of the messenger for their age and reiterate that message vigorously.
Amen.
They don't twist it. They don't change it. Misinformation produced death in Genesis. Misinformation made Ahab go up to the Syrian campaign and get that arrow through his heart. And 400 men tell him, "Oh, God will prosper." Misinformation cost him his life. Misinformation will cost you your life again. Man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Jesus said, "You will hear the truth and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free."
Amen.
You change that truth, it loses the effect of its intended purpose. It becomes a thing you play around with. Oh, it's become a religion of convenience. But when you leave it in its original form, you watch it do exactly what it's supposed to. This is my purpose of preaching this. People like to tweet. People like to change. People like to water down. Or leave it in its original form. Because this message was supposed to produce a super race and a super church. Leave it the way it is. Let's sing this little song. There's a voice calling me from an unknown tree. And the whispers, can you put on the board? Whatever it takes for my will to break.